It was very late at night, and a lonely woman walks down a dark street. There's fog everywhere. Out of the fog, a man emerges like a perverse magic trick. But before she can completely turn around, when she hears footsteps, his hands are around her neck. She is choked until unconscious, and then ripped apart with a 12-inch blade. This is not a made-up horror story. It is the work of Jack the Ripper. But who was Jack the Ripper? And why does he remain the most sought-after serial killer of all time? The story essentially started on August 31st, 1888, when the body of a woman named Marianne Nichols was found. Nichols had been seen alive approximately 1 hour before her body was discovered by someone at a common lodging house. As for the condition in which her body was found, brace yourself. It's a grisly one. Her throat was cut off by two cuts, one of which completely tore all the tissue down to the bone. The lower part of her abdomen was ripped apart and opened by a deep, jagged wound. And Jack didn't call it a day here. He made several other incisions inflicted to the right side of her abdomen with the same knife. All the wounds were made in a downward thrusting manner, so it was clear that the killer hadn't been precise at all. Rather, he just stabbed where he looked. How did the story progress? The public was just about to forget that someone amongst them was capable of committing the most atrocious crimes possible when 1 week later, Jack struck again. This time, a woman named Mary Chapman. Her body was found in the early morning lights in the same manner as Jack's first victim. Two severe cuts to the throat and the rest to the abdomen. But Jack took his time with this one. So instead of realizing that the poor woman was trying to live and call the police, he utilized his time by removing her intestines. Besides the obvious disgust at mutilation, we're honestly confused. This murder provided slight insight to who the culprit was. An eyewitness stated that she had seen Chapman with a man in a long dark overcoat and a hat talking to Chapman. Of course, that is the most generic description possible and could be used to describe at least 99% of the male population at the time. Jack wasn't put off by the fact that despite his attempts at being edgy by committing murder, he was still basic in appearance, and he struck again, twice. We're going to state the next number in two lines because it's not very interesting. Jack the Ripper slit someone's throat once, got interrupted, had to dash, but his fourth victim suffered the consequence of Jack not having a life. He dealt with her calmly. He had loads of time on his hands. The fourth victim was a woman named Catherine. Her body was found the same day the third victim was. Get ready for the description of her state. Her throat had been slit in the classic Jack manner. This time, he made two slits, and of course, how could he leave without ripping apart her abdomen? But Jack didn't stop there. He mutilated her face by cutting off her nose, slashing her cheeks, and making incisions through her eyelids. The lobe of her right ear was discovered in her pocket. The police surgeon at the time stated that these incisions would have at least taken 5 minutes. Unless you're part of the mafia, in which case, hello, consider finding us, you won't know that when you have to commit murder in a relatively public space, you kill the person and get out before anyone sees you or, in fact, even hears you. Jack had no such concerns, making him either very stupid or brave, which is not keeping with the rest of his image. This case again provided some leads. A section of Catherine's bloody apron was found at the entrance of a boarding house. An inscription directly above the apron said, "The Jews will not be held responsible for anything." The message appeared to have said that a Jew or multiple Jews were responsible for this murder, but it is unclear whether the writing was coincidental or not. The police commissioner feared riots against Jews, so he had the writing washed before dawn. Now wait. Jack still went on. This would be his final murder, but his most gruesome one. The final victim was Mary Jane Kelly, and her body was discovered extensively mutilated in the room she lived alone in. Her face had been hacked beyond recognition, as in there was nothing left there to identify her. Her throat was cut all the way to her spine, and of course Jack couldn't leave without slashing her abdomen. But Kelly's abdomen was emptied of all of her organs. Her kidney was placed under her head. Sections of her leg and abdomen were also placed on the table. Her heart was missing from the crime scene. If that didn't disturb you, get off Reddit and get therapy.
Each of these five murders became more and more terrifying, except for the third one, which was interrupted. But honestly, why do we assume all these women were murdered by the same man? Mostly due to old documents, such as a letter written by the police surgeon to the head police, which stated that Jack had murdered only five women, the ones we mentioned above. So Mary Jane Kelly is considered to be Jack Ripper's final and most unfortunate victim, but the fact is, the murders didn't stop then. After Kelly, four more women saw their murders. We'll leave the first two because it's just strangulation and a sloppier version of Jack's killing style. Let's move on to the third, and let us warn you, it is way more gruesome than Kelly's. In fact, it's so gruesome that we didn't even know the victim's name, and the body was named as the Pynchon Street Torso. Yeah, that single word of fear-inducing. In her late 30s or 40s, bruising about the victim's back and arms indicated that she had been severely beaten before her death. The victim's abdomen was extensively mutilated, and she had been one day before the discovery. The next victim was discovered in the same manner, head and legs missing, but also torso and arms present. The murders after these were also brutal, but not to this degree. Now we understand why everyone was addicted to opium back in the day. It was a horrible time. After all that running around and murdering, how did one catch Jack the Ripper? Well, it wasn't for the lack of trying. Investigations and politicians combined their forces to seek out the perpetrator. Due to the nature of the mutilations, butchers, surgeons, and physicians were suspected. So, in conclusion, Jack was not found and lived out all of his life as a pathetic but free man. There are many varied theories as to his identity, but the authorities could not agree on a single one. And despite the continued interest in the Ripper's identity, he still remains unknown. Do you think there's a chance we will find out who Jack the Ripper was? Comment down below and we'll pin the best one.